Oh, wow. Fine. Did that puzzle. I think I did that puzzle fairly well when I did it. Hello, hi, the stream's not late, you're late. The stream's definitely not late. No, you're crazy. You're crazy. It's not late. It's not late. It's not like when I was told when dinner was, I didn't misunderstand completely. And it's not like I was just watching a goddamn ton, oh wait, no, can't say that, oh no, YouTube won't like that, but YouTube might like that I kept watching YouTube shorts for the past 8 hours. I hate short form media. I hate short form media so much. I hate it. Because you're like, oh, it's just, you just like, okay, next one. 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 Okay, oh, I hate this one. Ew. Ew, dislike. Don't show me this. Okay, next one. Okay, next one. Ew. It's just, ew. Ew. Ew, don't like that. Don't show me that ever again. Okay, next one. Okay, oh, that's cute. Okay, next one. Okay, next one. Short form entertainment. I prefer binged content. But dang human nature, we love those short forms. What I hate, you know what I hate the most though? Like genuine hate. I hate when it loops. And obviously all of them loop. But when it's like, and that's why you'll never believe, and like it cuts to the beginning part where it says, like it'll start with, you'll never believe that this girl did a thing. She did a thing, and it was very cool. And that's why you'll never believe that this girl did a thing. And it just loops like that infinitely. And it's like, I despise that. I despise that so much. It is so infuriating. I hate it. Anyways, we are not here for that. We are here for Layton. We're here for difficult puzzles, easy puzzles, and me questioning my sanity for either. Without further ado, our story so far! After the levitation incident in Gallery Plaza, Dalston was taken into police custody. He looks a lot shorter than I expected. I am actually, if... They are the same level. I am shocked that she's taller than him. That is fascinating. Professor Layton heads to City Hall to speak with Detective Bloom regarding Dalston's interrogation. Were we doing that? I don't remember. I think we just did your puzzle. We didn't have any of those to do left, which is good. Should we go in and see if we have a puzzle in here? Hi, lady, do you have a puzzle for me? You do. Are you finally here to let me fix you up?
Thank you, but no. I do appreciate your gracious repeated offer, even though I'm pretty sure you're going to charge me an arm and a leg for that, Madame Lepushka.
Shame. Don't think you can waltz out of here without solving a puzzle, though.
I love those things.
Oh, then why am I giving it to you? The heck is this? Days of Rest. Mr. B, now then, as you know, we're all going to close our shops for one day a week, but we all have to pick a different day. The other shopkeepers already circled the days they'd be happy with, so it's just you two left. I'll close on whichever day as long as it's not Sunday. Oh, I'll just close on the day before Mr. A. Wait, oh, I'll just close on the day before Mr. A. That's okay, right? In the end, which day did each of the seven shopkeepers take? I feel like this is manipulative. Be like, hey, everyone has to be closed on one day of the week. Choose. In the end, Oh, I'll just choose the day before Mr. A. That's okay, right? The other shopkeeper's already circled it, but we all have to pick a different day. The shopkeeper's already circled the days. Wait. They only have to be- wait. Okay, some of these are closed 3 days a week. Some of these are closed 2 days a week. We all have to pick a different day. The other shopkeepers already circled the days they'd be happy with, so it's just you two left. In the end, which day did each of the seven shop- that circle's not choosing. Okay. Cool. Well, first I'd have to figure out what day they would choose. The issue with that is, okay, who has the least? You two have the least, but I'm gonna say you are choosing that because your other option pairs with those guys. So I'm gonna say you, by default, have to choose that. Just because I'm biased. And by doing that, I'm then gonna say that you choose that. You can't choose that now. I could make you choose that and that. And then they could choose... I'll just close the day before Mr. A. That seems not incorrect. I hope that there's multiple solutions. This seems accurate to everything. That is the day before. I will close on whichever day as long as it's not Sunday. Any day and any day before him. So, no one else is taking Saturday, so you might as well take Saturday. And by default, then that would mean that you have to take that day. So I'm saying that I'm correct and I'm a genius.
Don't keep me in suspense.
Yay. I'm a genius.
There is no puzzle without a solution.
Hurrah for me! They arrange their days off as follows. Mr. A on Saturday, Mr. B on Tuesday, Mr. C on Friday, Mr. D on Monday. Once you realize that Mr. A's day off must be Saturday, I did it backwards. I did it backwards then. Oops. I mean, I think my logic was sound, though, because it's like there were only two choices for one of the top ones, only two choices for the one of the bottom ones. So it's like, okay, we'll choose this one, because why not? And it just worked out that I chose the right one to disqualify first. Or to remove from the equation first. It worked out, it's fine. That intellectual error isn't just an act, if only the clothes were.
Leaving that aside for the moment, did you hear there was an arrest in the case of the masked gentleman?
Oh yes, Alphonse, that is quite a stinker of an arrest, if you ask me, darling. What evidence do they have against him? Let me guess, none? Or is it very little? He's not very good with people, sure, a little rough around the edges, maybe, but even his own businesses have been harmed. I just don't see it.
I think the police are wrong about Dalston.
And that would mean that the real criminal is still out there.
Yes, while everyone is focused on Dalston, the real culprit is free to roam.
It seems the police are over-eager beavers to call this case closed, no? That is an interesting point, making it seem like they want to just brush it under the rug. That it's like, oh, we're finished, we're done. It's like... makes me think someone in the police force might be involved. I don't want to talk to you. I really don't want to. I'm willing to skip the puzzle just because I really don't want to talk to her. Let's just go where we need to go. We can do that, and we're going to do that because we... oh, okay, we have to talk to this. You weren't here before. Oh, good, you don't have the puzzle.
Have you folks been to Pumpkin Park? Well, have you ate some me?
Yes, the amusement park. We haven't been there yet. Why do you ask so loudly?
I heard the masked gentleman is said to appear there tonight. It's gonna be wild.
You seem rather excited about it. I just hope he doesn't cause too much panic.
What if the Ferris wheel comes off and goes rolling through the park? Or what if a roller coaster car just goes flying through the air?
Okay. I'm wondering if that latter one is going to happen, either now or in the future, because one of those has happened! Very curious! In this not-so-tiny village. Anyways.
Oh, what if the horses on the carousel come alive and turn wild? I need to calm down.
Well, if any of those would be kind... Well, any of those would be kind of neat, actually. I mean, investigatively speaking, of course.
Has anyone actually been harmed so far? I mean, the horses could have caused trampling. People could have caused trampling just in general, running in fear. So any of these events could have actually caused harm.
I'm with you, lady. I'm staying as far away from there as possible.
You were excited. Whatever, you weird clown. You weird clown. Oh, hi, Grandma. Not Eustace. Whatever her name is. Esther, right.
Ursula, my lad, did you hear the police made an arrest? They really did it.
Yes, they arrested Alphonse Dalston.
What? Absurd! I've known that boy all his life. That boy can't keep his mouth shut. If he were behind this, we'd all know it.
That's an interesting way to defend him.
If he was saying it, he'd be bragging about it. Little shit.
I agree, essentially. Unfortunately, the police seem quite convinced otherwise.
That's too bad. I was so proud of them for making an arrest, you know. And now I feel like they're idiots. I have zero faith in humanity now.
We are currently gathering evidence that will clear Alphonse.
What is happening to this town? All of the chaos, Alphonse arrested, and this puzzle!
Puzzles are normal in our society. What the hell is this? Why? Like, literally, this has nothing to... Esther, why?
I don't know, I found it at the cross, next to the crossword. I thought you'd like it.
This little purple ant wants to cross a sea of pencils to join its red friend. It always walks on top of the pencils and can only go along each pencil once. It's too small to climb up from one pencil onto another. As the situation is now, the ant will not be able to get from its starting point to its goal at the red arrow. However, by moving just one colored pencil, you can help it reach the goal. Which colored pencil should you move? The one it's on. The fact that I saw that it was on it, I'm like, what are you, stupid? The one it's on! Just put it there!
I believe I have this one.
I would have been upset if that wasn't the right answer. Like, come on!
Excellent.
That has to be the right answer. It's the pink pencil the ant is standing on. If you move it on the bottom right corner, the ant can walk it straight to the goal and be reunited with its friend. So much for the sea of pencils. That would be bafflingly stupid otherwise. I'm like, that was one of those, it's the match. It's like, what's the first thing you have to light? It's the match. I guess a better thing would be the dolls that were reversible in the last game. I forget, what story was I saying? Was I saying the story about a police officer that came to my house or that I had to break into my own house? Ironically, the police officer came the Friday before I broke into my house on that Monday.
My parents were in Hawaii when I had to break into my own house. I took the trash out. The door locked behind me. Well, actually, no, I was getting the trash in. That's a story I've said before, but I get to share it again for anyone that's new. We're never doing this.
I can't imagine little Dolston being under suspicion for any of this.
Some evidence at the scene appears to point to Alphonse, but he isn't the criminal, I'm certain of it.
You're such a sensible boy, Herschel. Just like that little Randall. Well, if the police won't do their job, we'll have to do it for them. I'll watch out for the real criminal.
Go home. Esther, just go home and be safe. It's not that hard, but whatever.
Hello again, Professor Layton. The suspect in the mass gentleman incident is currently being interrogated.
That is Alphonse Dolston, correct?
Wow, you are good. Yes, Chief Sheffield and Detective Bloom are talking to him now. You've been cleared, so please go on in.
I love going on in.
I feel like I'm going to go to the back, just based on how that is very center of map. I can talk to you, you, and you. I guess we'll talk to you first. And you have a puzzle. I heard they made an arrest. Then I realized it was our police force, so it's probably the wrong guy.
Oh, come on! Are they really that bad?
This wouldn't be the first wrongful arrest in Matador. It also wouldn't be the 15th, just saying.
Last time they got their man, the tile pattern in this puzzle was in style.
Okay, the first game had the issue where a lot of the puzzles did not relate, but the fact that they're trying to relate some of these puzzles that have no relation at all kills me. I'd rather it be, man, I'm stuck on this puzzle and I can't think straight. You know what? No, that's what happened more in the first game, and I like it for that, because it's like, oh, I've been struggling with this puzzle for weeks! It's like, it works. It makes sense. It works perfectly. We've done one of these before. Okay. Nope, you have to go back. You can go there. You go down. Go there. You go there. You go there. Pixel art. I only have two of those left. One up there, no. You two have to wait your turn. You need to move, no, there. God, I would not stand, I know this is a wall, but I would not stand on this to save my life, because that would crack instantly.
Just split the tiles!
Give yourself a pat on the back, and a nice cup, and I like coffee.
I detest coffee.
Oh, new shop in the apparel.
The police seem a little quick to make an arrest and call it a day. They say Dolston was at the scene of the crime. Hello? Who wasn't there? The real crook probably vanished into the crowd.
True, it would be very easy to slip in and out of a crowd like that. That one.
If being there counts as evidence, you gotta arrest half the town. Just saying.
One of the many reasons I dislike coffee, besides the scent alone, is that I worked at a grocery store that gave out free coffee, and people would just leave it around or throw it in the trash bins at every register. And if you had to throw away the trash at the end of your shift when working in retail,
and you got a nice scent of garbage from every register of, like, just rank, like, things that just in there all day, and just liquid coffee in almost every bag. The nice aroma as you seal the bag and you just get a waft of cheap-ass coffee and disgusting garbage. I hated coffee before then. That didn't make it any more appetizing, and I'm sorry for those that love it. If you love it, you love it, and fair to you. I hate it. Anyways, to the mayor! He is a puzzle.
Who would have thought the Master Man was one of our most prominent citizens? I don't quite understand it all, but the police have assured me that priests would have now returned to Mondor.
I love how they first said that it's like, oh, the accomplice. Now they're claiming the mastermind. It's like, they're lying to the mayor himself. Excuse me?
We sure do appreciate your help in the investigation.
That is a weird-ass mustache. Please never touch it again. Please stop moving. I don't like to see it move. It upsets me.
Perhaps you could lend another hand. I can't get the puzzle out of my head, and I need all the room I can get in there.
Yeah, clearly. I mean, you have room in your butt. Oh, no. God dang it. Into four sections that are the same shape, are of equal area, and each contain three pawns. To make complicate matters worse, you want at least one white and one black pawn in every section. Okay. But I need three pawns, so at least. Okay. How many are there of each? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I have to make 4. So 6 does not easily... I need... Wait. Okay. For now, I'm just gonna box off random ones. And the rest, it doesn't matter. If I just say that, hey, those two are valid, those two are valid. They have to be the same shape. Now that's not... Actually, no, that... No, wait. Three pawns, so no, this is not valid.
God damn it.
This technically would be valid. No. Okay, that worked. That would still be valid. This is far from valid. This is extremely valid. Okay, that is valid now. That doesn't seem... No, it's not. No, it's not valid. Oh, golly gee. This is still a fair shape, currently. The issue being that you have way too many, you greedy boo-boo. Huh. The issue with this is that I would have to make a divot in here.
which I cannot do. But I could do the reverse. Excuse me. I can't do that. Wait. No, I can't do that. Thinky brain. I will try to do the think. I'm not the best at it. Oh, thinky brain. I'ma try to use this thing that's inside my skull called a brain. Thinky brain. Thinky brain. 1, 2, 3, go down. Now go there, right there. Now go right over there. Don't know why I'm singing Christmas, don't know why at all. Thinky brain. 1, 2, 3, do do boo dee do 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 do. Hey, thinky brain, this doesn't fit shapes. 1, 2, 3, da do boopy. Do 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 do. No, that's right. But then I have this middle thingy, which you need a friend. That is your pokey bit. So your pokey bit. No. Your pokey bit. Then your pokey bit. Then your pokey bit. You are missing a friend! Who didn't give you a friend? I mean, I know it was me, but who didn't give you a friend? That's very rude of them. Whoever didn't give you a friend? Where's your friend gonna come from? I have no idea where your friend is gonna come from. Also, I don't like that shape. For a whole host of reasons, now that I look at it a second time. I hate these puzzles for that reason, because it's like, why do you, like, it always has to be symmetry. It almost always has to be symmetry, and it's like, when you get a symmetrical shape, you don't want to make that! hate it. Don't ever, like, that, no. Ugh. Tis bad. Wait, actually, same shape. They cannot be mirrored. Damn it. If I just do this. Currently this fails the, like, it needs a friend. You are missing one. It needs four separate sections. That won't help. I hate this. Stupid puzzle. You have four and you have four, so you need to share. I wager a bet to say that you could share from... Actually, it probably should be shared from the middle blip. But then if I share from the middle blip, you lose your middle blip, which is bad. You need your if I take from you, that doesn't help you. That doesn't help you at all. You're now alone. You're very lonely. That's not fun for you. I don't like this. You need a friend. You desperately need a friend who can be there for you when you need it. You need a friend. Desperately need a friend who will be there for you when you need it. Woohoo. Who will be there for you when you need it. You need a friend who will be there for you when you need it. You need a friend who will be there for you when you need it.
There for you when you need it.
Okay. I need it. You are missing two. You're fine. You're a greedy son of gun, and you're fine. So I almost want to say, take that, take two, which is a game. Okay, now you have three friends. But this isn't going to help you, and it's not going to help you, and also we still just now have a square in the center, and I've just made corners, and that does not help anyone. At all. God damn it. The other thing is, I am thinking about corners and not non-corners. Like, I'm not thinking about just basic shapes. Well, quote-unquote basic. They're far from basic shapes. One, two, three. One, two, three. Two, bop, 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 bop. Two, three. One, two, three. Let's just start with symmetry and see where that leads us. Also, I don't think that this is symmetrical. I don't think it is. One, two, three, to the side. One, two, three to the side. Oop, point. So one, two, three to the side. There we go. Now that literally helps almost nothing, interestingly enough. Like, very much it helps nothing. If I go up, up, up. No, 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 no. I do not like this puzzle. It has to be the same shape. Why does it always have to be the same shape?
I don't know!
Okay. If I grab those two, then okay, you're fine. You are quote unquote fine. You are not yet fine. You now have two. If I grab the one next to it, that doesn't help you. You have more than enough, so you literally do not need any. If I go one further, You then have three. You then have three, and you still have, or you have two, and you have two. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Take off that. Which is that part. Which is that part. Which is that part. Which is that part. Put that there. Put that there. Put that there. Put. That's not the same shape. Because I didn't count right. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're still missing two. You're still missing one. Oh, you are still missing one. You're not missing any. You're fine. You two are fine. That doesn't help. If I grabbed these two, you would then get that. Oh, wait. Oh my god. This is a witness puzzle. And this is I know the rules to the witness, so it's like half the game wouldn't have a point other than me trying to figure out which panel wants me to do thing. But it's like half the game is figuring out what it wants you to do in the first place, not how, like, what is the answer to current panel. What is problem to current panel is the puzzles there. The issue, well, wait, 1, 2, 3. Overall, there are 12 pieces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So, they can be divided up 3 by 3. Currently, you need a white one. You would then need the black one. Two, three, four. I feel like I've done this shape before. You have enough. You have too many, so you have to share. Okay. Now there's not enough for you. I hate this. Too many. I don't know the best way to even go about these, to be honest. Because how is the memo even going to help with this? Like, oh yeah, pair these three. Pair these three. Pair these three and pair these three. Is there shapes I can make with that? And the issue is, if I take it away, then I can't see my shapes anymore, so that doesn't help me. It'd probably make more sense to pair these three. Pair these three. Pair these three, and then pair these three. But I don't even know if that's possible. Put this 6x6 into four sections that are the same shape. Of course, it has to be four specific sections. That... I don't think that that will... Or at least not... I feel like part of the trap is that they are touching, and I should ignore the fact that they are touching in some cases. Like, maybe I should just attach those together. Maybe I should attach these together. Maybe I should attach these together. But that is such a long distance to get that, and it doesn't make a symmetrical pattern. Like, if I go back to just the corners bit. You're fine. You need a friend, and you need a friend. You need him, and you would then subsequently need him. Alternatively, if I do that, taking your neighbor... You're still missing one. You now have three. You don't have enough. You have too many now. I hate this.
I hate this so much.
I don't think that shape will even fit in the other ones. This'll fit. But then you have four, which is just no. You do not need four. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. One, two, one, two.
You still have four. Stop taking the fourth!
You go there, you go there, that is... You have three. So let's just say you get those two, for the hell of it. You get those two, for the hell of it. And this is just the corners again! That would literally just be the corners again. Which helps no one. I hate this.
So much!
Ugh! It's not even like a pattern thing that like I could just be like, okay, whatever, because those do not, they do not align, because that would have been a black one and then that's a white one. Nope, that's the wrong way. Point in, point in, point in, point in. You have four, you have three, you have two, you have two. Wait, no, you have five. I'm good at counting. Which then makes me think. Take from you. Give to you. Is then take from you, you still lack. And also, those are equal shapes. Those are equal shapes currently. Currently, those are very much equal shapes. They are just rotated in ways, which is good, because that means that they do not need to be exactly symmetrical. That is good. What's bad is... I don't know... Because you need to go here... But you're not there. If I just say, you're mine now, deal with it, then the other shapes need to deal with that. And you then are not a valid shape. Thinky brain. It's gonna think maybe one day. Thinky brain. See, now that's not valid. These two are valid, but it's a mirror, which it doesn't like. And if I do that, it doesn't like that. Pumpernickel. It's so close. It is so close. If you could just let me mirror it, it'd be fine. Game says no. Can't do that. No. Why would we let you do that?
I wonder. I wonder why.
And now you're missing your friend. This is like,
oh man, if you just said that, it'd be dandy. But you can't. But you can't.
Now your friends. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. No, it went down like that. You're missing a shape. Fuck you. You have nearly everything. Nearly everything. You have everything. You have everything. You have everything. You are missing half of your puzzle. For sake of it, just everyone takes a little bit. So now you have too many, you have too many, you have just enough, you still are short. You are short, you are short, you are fine, you have too many. Oh my god, am I about to go- I am about to go straight lines again.
Oh my god.
You have just enough. You have too many. One, two, three. One, yeah, you have way too many. You have way too many.
If I go that way. Right?
One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. You now have more! How did you do that? Take out that. You're still missing, friend. Puzzle? Who did the mayor give me this? Screw the mayor. Hate the mayor. The mayor's terrible. I never voted for him. He's a stupid man. Stupid man. Stupid man. Stupid bonehead. Stupid, stupid. Stupid, stupid. No. You didn't go down. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. You have enough. You have not enough. Ah! I hate this. I hate this a lot. Because if I try to grab it for you, it's like, oh, that's dandy. You're short. You're short. You're too much. You're too much. Dun 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 dun.
Misu just made like a spiral.
That I don't think helps me. You have three, you have four, you have two, you have three. No. I hate this so much. Give me a hint coin. Pawns are concentrated on one part of the board, so first consider how you could divide the chessboard into two. Then you can think about how to separate the pawns into equal numbers. If it is something like this, you know what? It probably freaking is, but vertically. You have three. Ball, so that's mirrored. These are shapes that work out the way that the current rules work. The issue is, give me another hand coin.
Give me another!
Divide the board into four sections as described in the puzzle. You'll need to have two sections with one white and two black pawns, and two sections with one black and two. That is the worst hint ever possible.
Separated into two. Okay. Make sure they're separated more. Okay. Oh, did you do it? No, your instructions were unclear. I made a table. How did you make a table? Out of a chessboard. Well, you see, I used all the pawns as legs. What a very short table, isn't it? Yeah, it was. It was a very short table I made. Made a very short table. I thought you'd like it. Made it very short.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like, come on! If the mirrored rule was not in play, everything would be hunky-dory.
But it's not. Because it sucks. And I hate it. I'm upset.
Divide it into two and then deal with it!
So then, halaba. But that does not work.
Doesn't. It does not work.
At all. In the slightest. Not even a teensy little bit. Doesn't work. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Now there are four here. That's not helpful.
Look, I made a pretty shape. Okay, brain. I disagree. There was a puzzle where two of the hints literally does not give you any info, and even the earlier hint says not to waste your hint coin unlocking the... That is a okay, fair. But then that is bad. That is bad on the developers. That is extremely bad on the developers. That is god-awful on the developers then. Screw, that is terrible. I mean, I'm glad one of the hints says don't use the other hint coins. But make better hints. Make better hints. You can't just be like, oh, this puzzle's so simple, you're overthinking it. No, give a better hint. Or just tell me the answer. If you're gonna say don't waste hint coins, just tell me the answer by that point. Because clearly you've made a puzzle that's so easy, you might as well just give me the answer. Like, that is flat-out garbage. Which game is that in? Which game is that in? I want to know. I want to be pissed at a specific game. It's the same issue every time. Every time. Need to look it up because I don't remember. Okay. But, I swear I've done this shape and it didn't work. You have three. You have three. You have two and two. So, take him, but by subsequently, you have to take him. And then by subsequently, you have to take him, which then gives you more. And then by subsequently, you take him, which you have enough, you have enough, you two are still missing. So then by there, I say, take those. Those are your friends now. They're your new friends. You get to pay rent together, friends. But then subsequently, oh, you're alone now, which sucks, you're alone. You know what happens, sometimes you're just alone. Now you have a friend. Now you have a friend. Wait, no, that's not right. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Okay. You steal him, now you're lonely. Because you lost your friend. You have two and you have two, so it's still two and two. God, you were just eating everything. Now this one only has one. No, he has two now. You have way too many. Stop.
Oh my God.
Okay.
I don't think that any of these should steal from these. Screw it. We've been at this for too long. Draw a line to make a clean cut through the middle, then cut each half into two. Draw a line to make a clean cut through the middle, then cut each half into two to make... Are you sh... How many times have I done this? Okay. No. Consider the distribution of the pawns. You'll first want to make a horizontal line through the middle. You can divide the top and the bottom halves after that. What? What does that mean? Like that? What? Make four quarters, cool. Oh my god, straight line. I have done this so many, how? Consider the distribution of the pawns. You'll first want to make a horizontal line through the middle. You can you literally just said the same thing twice. First, want to make a horizontal line through the middle. You can divide the top and bottom halves after that. I don't understand. I don't understand, because you're saying straight line in the middle. Okay. That is too many. And that is too many. That's not the right shape. This is still not the right shape. What? Consider the distribution of the pawns. You'll first want to make a horizontal line through the middle. You can divide the top and bottom halves after that. Okay. Straight horizontal line. I can't do that without I literally don't see this without doing a mirror. And I don't want to do the last, like, give me the answer one. I hate when it's more limited. I don't like the hints. The hints on this one have not really helped. Is that a fair thing for me to say, or am I just whining for the sake of whining because I haven't gotten it yet?
It's like, oh, it's so obvious. How have you not gotten it?
It's like, well, it's hard. I don't see it. Like, that doesn't work. This does not work. I don't see it. But are the hints fair or not? Because I feel like the second hint was just like, that should have... The second hint was literally like, hey, are you observant? Look. The third hint is, cut it in half. Now cut it in quarters. It's like... Wait, did I say the second or third? Whatever. I don't see it. Because if I do this, okay, that doesn't help me. I can't do that. They're pointing towards the answer, but yeah, they aren't super helpful. Is it a straight line? Is it a straight line in the middle? Like, it, no dips ups or down. I'm actually asking. Because I'm tired of this stupid puzzle. Okay. Is it symmetrical rotational wise? Where... can't. Where this is the same as this, this is the same as this, this is the same as this. If it was spinning around, it would always be the same 90 degrees. Or is it symmetrical in what I had like here? Where these two are the same. These two are the same, rotate them 180, and then they're all the same. I would have to assume it's the 180. But I have no idea how you would get that. If part of it is flat. So... is it like how if these two could be left the same, rotate these 180, and it's the same shape? Boop, boop, rotate it like 180, it's then boop and boop. Where then they are all the same. Versus if they were all the corners and then they just rotate. I mean, there can't be that many other ways that I can think of. Besides something like interlocking like that. But then that doesn't help. That gives you one more than you need, which does not help. And the staircase still doesn't help. Like, this is currently a valid shape, minus the pieces rule. if I took your blip there, the issue is I'm taking your blip there, which does it help? You have three, you have three, you have four now. Symmetry, 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 boobadee, but not mirror, just rotational symmetry, symmetry, ooh, boobadoobadee. La 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 bow, sha la 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 bow, ba da ba. Do 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 do. No, that doesn't work. Would you like? Yes, please. Thank you. Please tell me yes. I'll just shrink this preemptively. Okay. B2 D2 F3. Really? I gotta make an alligator! Oh my god, I gotta make an alligator! Oh, I would have never seen that. I would have never, ever thought of that shape. Ever. Thank you. We're free.
I believe I have this one.
We're free.
Solving puzzles is truly a
I don't
pleasure.
Deserve all those pickerettes, but I don't care. We're free.
Hey, Moon! It took forever! I knew a clever fella like you have no trouble with my little chest problem.
Yes, well, have you said something about the interrogation from Chef Sheffield? Chief, whatever the fuck, I don't know. I hate chess.
Professor, I thought you were good at
I hate chess.
Okay, do you need a glass of water?
I need a vodka.
I didn't know you drink.
I'm going to now.
Alright, I heard that Dulston was our man. And we'll know more after he confesses.
Also found the puzzle I was talking about earlier. Last Spectre, Spectre 132. The puzzle is a visual one, figuring out where the resulting image would be. Did I do that puzzle? You know what? I could bet you that I did that puzzle and either struggled with it or got it, like, in 2 seconds.
I'm sure Sheffield will appreciate any more help you can offer.
Thank you, Mayor. I never want to speak to you or your ilk again. It's refreshing to be treated to such excellent refreshments. I looked at the book. You can't drink a book. I haven't been around, able to wring a confession out of Dulston. You sure he's our man? No, I'm not. I believe Alphonse is innocent, Inspector. I suspect the masked gentleman will appear just as announced.
Mr. Dulston is so much invested in this town, it doesn't make sense.
Pumpkin Park is the next target. I am directly telling the police this so they are aware. Unless we can stop the masked gentleman soon, there will be another incident tonight. If I were to charge here, I'd throw a few more extra patrols down there right now.
We're probably going to go over because we started late and that puzzle.
Sounds like Chief Sheffield believes that he already has the culprit. He has already put the patrol officers back on their regular schedule.
That is scary.
Then get to the briefing room, Layton. You talk some sense into Sheffield and he'll ignore you. And you, I have really tight. Oh my god. That hand does not look healthy. Like, your hand is not that. Oh, that is some bad. Ew, that is some bad vertex mapping.
Ew, that is some bad weight painting. Ew. Oh my god, that, ugh. What is this, Kingdom Hearts?
Layton, glad you made it. We're about to start the interrogation.
Thank you for letting us sit in, Detective.
Of course, another set of eyes and ears might help us catch Dalston in a lie.
He's an innocent man.
I'm not Dalston. But make this quick. Why did you do it?
For the last time, Sheffield, I'm innocent. Why aren't you out looking for clues instead of harassing me?
Don't give me that. Oh, I'm innocent, indeed. Because you use a horse drive cart in a saturated smoke gun. That's been a cut out of the scene. But Mr. Cartwright, you give me your accomplices, your acceptors, to tell us what you did and how you had help from the judge of my commission on you.
I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't do anything. Where's my lawyer?
Stuck in traffic. You got a cart.
Actually, you have to then, assuming this is like American law, you then have to shut up. If he refuses to speak with you until his lawyer's there, you cannot force him to tell you anything.
Dalston, we found tracks from a horse cart on the sheet. I'm going to add 2 and 2. It's 4.
Yeah, but how does that have to do with him?
Maybe you should be out talking to the guy who runs the horse track. You've got plenty of cuts there, don't they? What would I gain by scaring people? My business depends on tourists.
Dalston, we can do anything either way, or anything the other way that not so easy. Did they easy us again? He confirmed that all the cards from the track were connected for. You're all there except Brandon got spotted. If they got cheap, who could afford to buy one of those on the road? The car is before the horse here, Dalston. We've also got a justice. This is the door of the church in your marriage proposal. So you're taking revenge on Mr. Ventura.
I hate this voice. Why did I do this?
You can escape the former butler, got rich, and married your woman. Only I need water. Mr. Ledore told us everything.
Mr. Ledore needs to shut up. Henry said that. Why, the next time I see that dirty little, I'm going to politely ask him what he meant by that. And then I'll show him my slug collection. And baseball bats. Detective Sheffield mentioned finding carriage tracks at the statue incident. What do you know about those?
A harness racing cart was somehow used in the stone statue incident.
Interesting. The entire incident certainly preyed on the psychology of crowds, where calm people can quickly turn hysterical. If one person were to fake an affliction, a crowd would form. This would obscure the subject and worry the onlookers.
Exactly. And with the crowd distracted, the others could do as they wished, such as wheeling some hidden statues out on carts. Once the statues were in place, the accomplices could start screaming that some people had turned to stone.
This would trigger a panic. The worried crowd would promptly forget about the first afflicted individual and attempt to flee. As they ran, they would have seen several statues, which would intensify their fear.
I couldn't have said it better, Professor.
But Professor, we didn't see any carts there that night. Where could someone keep those statues hidden in front of all those witnesses?
There was only one hiding place large enough, and we were all looking right at it.
What was it?
The balloon!
The cart must have been hidden inside the giant clown balloon.
Hidden inside the balloon? How?
I'm Layton. Well, we all saw a very large, colorful clown balloon during the parade, but few people noticed the cluster of supporting balloons.
And when the supporting balloons popped, the clown came crashing into the crowd.
Yes, the weight of the cart sent the balloons plummeting to the ground. Once it lost its support.
An extremely agile, sturdy, and expensive cart vehicle was needed to quickly distribute those statues onto the street.
And Dulston is the chief suspect because of his wealth.
Exactly. None of these stunts come cheap. Buying such a cart and paying off several accomplices would be very expensive. He has the means and the motive. I doubt we'll see another appearance from the masked gentleman as long as we have Dulston in custody.
I hope you're right, Detective. I hope you're right.
Your ominous tone notwithstanding, I'm certain that we have our man.
You don't. And if the masked gentleman does appear?
Well, then we'll have to rethink things. If he does appear, we may need to approach him directly about this mask of order.
I see. We still need to investigate a few leads. Thank you for your time, Detective.
Why do you care about the Mask of Order, and were you present when he mentioned that?
I don't think you were.
I'm curious about these horse racing carts. Let's investigate the racetrack.
Please, let me know what you find.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba-da-ba! Yay!
Oh, that got updated. The petrification miracle was nothing more than an elaborate trick. The perpetrators used the activity of the parade as cover while they mentioned the statues and convinced others that these were actually petrified people. All the culprits had to do was position the statues and then claim they saw them turn into stone. This created a panic from the... So that is complete. Yes, that... Or at least so far stated. I'm not worried about those not being complete, because in the past game, it has had moments where, like, anything wasn't solved until the very end. Let's go to the horse track, wherever it is. I guess it's north.
We need evidence to prove Dulston innocence. I'd like to find the actual cart that was mentioned in the interrogation.
Dulston spoke of a racetrack, but Sheffield said they already checked there.
We should see if they missed anything, because they probably did.
Oh, right. Horses. Oh, no.
If we can prove the cart that left the tracks was taken from the racetrack, we may be able to clear Dulston.
I saw the racetrack on a map back at the hotel. It's just north of here, which is convenient.
Well, then, what are we waiting for? Let's just go north of here. It's just north of here. Let's go. I want to go north. North we go.
I don't want to talk to her. She's the other psycho. I don't want to talk to her, and I refuse. I fear the horses.
You can buy a ticket for the chariot race here.
They posted the names of the favorite horses up here.
How much is a ticket?
You can't gamble, Luke.
God damn it!
No swearing either.
God flip it!
The better.
Sounds like a lot is going on in there.
Sounds like an awful lot of anticipation soon to be replaced by the silence of regret. Concern.
And we're off, ladies and gentlemen!
Wow! Everybody's so excited!
I need
Looks
to get
like
in, like an announcer voice
seconds.
Effect.
There goes my yacht!
That's
there
it.
Goes my yacht!
I would wager that he lost his bet.
Looks like they're using some of the cards right now, Professor.
Yes, I'd like to find out where they keep the cards.
Right, we should find the person in charge here, perhaps this fellow here.
You are very much ahead. Also, look at these horse, these low poly horses. Are these horses or donkeys? Found a hint coin to make up for the hint coins that were wasted. I found a puzzle, which means we're screwed.
Ugh, look at this mess. Oh, I think I see a toy bunny in there. Much like the real bunny that we haven't seen in days, and I never will. I used to have one just like that. Don't talk about the bunny. Oh my god!
It's fine. It's fine. These are not as bad. 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 Actually, this one seems very simple. Whew!
I'm going for it.
Woo! Oh my god, that was easy. That was piss easy.
Well, that's that.
What an okay, but how many turns did, like, is there no minimum? Oh, that was good. You really have a knack for anything dealing with animals, Luke.
Well, they're my friends! And I have no friends otherwise.
That's depressing.
I know.
Good day, I'm Gustav, the manager here. How can I help you fine folks today?
My name is Ocean Layton, and I'm looking into the case of the masked gentleman at the request of Mrs. Lador. Might I ask you some questions? Are you the masked gentleman?
Only to help. Only too happy to help. Although I'm quite busy here with this puzzle.
I'll solve it for you.
No, no, let me solve it.
I won one race and lost another. I didn't make it to the final.
I'm just glad I beat A.
If only I lost to B. If only I hadn't lost to B. First, they held races of two, then the winners raced against
each one,
while the losers battled for third. Okay, that's easy. D lost to B, which is like, ooh. I'm just glad I beat A. I won one race and lost another. So yeah, that has to be correct.
I believe I have this one.
By Jove, I got it!
An excellent puzzle.
I'm not an idiot. Hooray!
Look at that man! I'm just glad to be here!
Didn't sound very happy about the result, did he? I mean, he looks happy. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm just glad to be here, everyone! Thank you for inviting me.
Ooh, weird wet wilds.
Oh, thank you. You had some questions.
Do you remember anything unusual on the night of the stone statue incident?
Unusual? I don't believe so. It's quite uneventful here overall.
Do you recall if any of the cards had been removed recently?
Why, yes, actually. One of our cards was sent out for repairs. It was fixed about a month ago. I was shocked to see it had broken down again.
It was sent for repairs, and I like chocolate. It was sent for repairs and came back broken.
They're quite heavy, though. Very tough to move around without a horse.
We'd like to take a look at it, one. All the carts being used right now?
There may be one in the garage. You're welcome to take a look.
First, we're gonna deal with a robot. I have to read.
Oh my god, I have to read.
Dulcin under security, scrutiny, reading. Rumors must have spread like wildfire. Everyone in the city seems to know about last night's events. Detective Bloom claims that the tracks seen near the site of the statues match one of Dulcin's carts. I presume that a cart must have been involved in the incident, but I could never have foreseen this. The cart in question is sitting at the racetrack, so we'll be heading there to investigate further. Clue: the racetrack. The racetrack we went to investigate was bursting with spectators. I had never before seen carriage races such as these. The carts seem well-equipped for a quick getaway. I would like to investigate one of these carts. Perhaps the manager can assist. And also, maybe there's evidence of the flying man's, how he flew when we were chasing after him with a horse. Damaged cart. Manager of the racetrack, Gustav, informed us that the cart we are looking for...
Technically, he didn't. He said a cart.
Had been removed for maintenance just a few days prior to the stone statue incident. He was kind enough to grant us permission to explore the grounds as we please. Robot.
Robot time!
Okay, I can't go left because the mouse would be upset. And by the mouse would be upset, I mean I would lose. I could follow the mouse. I can go up. I feel like I need to go left. And by left, I mean right. I said left because I was thinking of 3D models. I feel like I need to go left again. I feel like I need to go left again. I feel like that those two mistakes were bad. That might not be anything. I do feel like I need to go down, and I do feel like I need to go down. I have to go up. I have to go down. I would hit the rat. And by rat, I mean mouse. If I go that way, go up. Go that way. Yeah, that's walking right into the mouse. Ew. Is that in front of the mouse? That will be in front of that mouse. Undo. No reset. Go that way, so that way the mouse is going the opposite direction. Go that way, so that way we're in the rhythm of the mouse. Go down. Follow mouse. Go up. I need the mouse to be here. No.
Maybe I don't need it to be there. I need to go that way, maybe. Going that way will kill me. Going up will not kill me. Going this way brings me back to start. This is the only way to go left. I missed the mouse. If I go this way, yeah, it's right there. I can follow the mouse and be fine. I can go away from the mouse and not be fine. I could go up and not be fine. That is where we would both be. But if I go up again, go this way. Can I kill both? I kill neither. I feel like I have to stall a bit. Now the mouse is following me. I don't know if this is the sink that I would want it to be. I don't think it is, because I think they are perfectly in line. So that might have been a mistake overall. If I go up, that's not good. I'm running out of battery, which is bad. But I win. Woo! I'm pretty sure there were less moves to do that in. Okay, robot done. Four more robots left. And store. Oh boy.
What the hell is that?
Oh, it's a Layton hat. Or not a Layton hat, Luke hat. It's a trendy cap. Very weird options for clothes. So says I. Nothing can fit in these. So why even have those be there? Huh. I can fit a shoe here, so I feel like I should. And if I can, I will. So I'll put a tie there, and if I have a tie there, then I might as well have a hat here. And if I have a hat here, I'll have this hat here. Hopefully, whatever I do will not be like, oh, you have this next to each other. I love when things are next to each other, yeah. And then be upset at me. Shoe doesn't fit. Shoe doesn't fit. No, no, no. 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 Well, I can't do that. Shoe doesn't fit. No, no, no. Shoe doesn't fit. No, no, no. The only way to get the shoes to connect. Get that out of there. That should work. 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 Where's chat? There it is. It was sent for repairs and I like chocolate. Perfect timing indeed. I try. And by try, I mean I don't try. I just do what I'm told. He sees the shoe, he loves the shoe, he wants 50 of those things. Hell yeah. I did it. I win. Back to story! Actually, I'm going to save! Because we have it saved in a bit. Sorry, got distracted. Right, bottom screen. Right. The thing that is the bottom.
Would this have been the type of cart used in the stone statue incident?
If so, I can see why the criminal would choose this. It's very sturdy.
You could transport quite a bit in one of these, Professor, and very quickly.
How many could you? Because they look small.
Let's take a closer look at this one. It is sturdy and heavy. It would be a challenge to remove one from the track quickly and quietly.
Criminal could have ridden it out of here.
Yes, but that would have left tracks leading from here to the sea. The police would have noticed that, I think.
Besides, to ride one out of here, you'd need a horse to pull it. A missing horse would raise some eyebrows.
Wait a moment.
What is it, Professor?
Interesting. Take a closer look here. These bolts, with a few turns, one could easily disassemble this cart. No doubt these carts are much easier to transport when they're in separate pieces. One could transport the pieces and later reassemble the cart.
If you carried it around in pieces, it would be much less conspicuous.
But wouldn't someone here notice if you were taking apart one of the carts?
A good question, Luke. Let's speak with Gustav here. Gustav! I'm looking at this one first.
Surely this big cart isn't for racing, is it?
That must be for carrying things. I wonder what.
You could fit four people in there.
Gustav, what is the process for removing carts from the premises?
You mean for repairs? Well, each cart would have to be signed out, and the repair order would need to be signed by the track owner, Mr. Lador.
Oh, you don't say! You don't say!
Would you like to see the repair records?
I very much would. Yes, that would be all right, if that would be all right.
I've lost the voice. I don't see why not. I'm very fancy and official looking for a horseman.
Oh, bitch, he guilty. Interesting.
Is it?
The cart we were just looking at was out for routine maintenance at the same time of the statue incident occurred.
Surely you're not suggesting that there's a connection between this cart and the nefarious masked gentleman?
I very much am. Oh my god, oh my god!
And then they just go, oh, together.
Simply one of the several possibilities. And yes, Henry signed the repair order.
Of course, our standard procedure is that no cart can be removed from the premises without Mr. Lador's approval. Mr. Lador was here today, actually. You just missed him.
Henry was here.
Yes, he had just come from the scene of last night's incident, apparently. I guess he came across some art pieces draped in drop cloths for the museum. He spoke to the curator about them.
Drop cloths. Interesting. Thank you, Gustav. You've been most helpful. I believe our next stop should be the Lador residence.
I agree. We really haven't yet had a chance to speak at length with that asshole.
Isn't he bound to be busy, Professor? I mean, he is an asshole after all.
I believe he'll make time for us. That fucking asshole. We're gonna go slam a book at him. This is not Layton anymore. Layton is gone.
One of the carts being out for repair during the statue incident can't be coincidence.
Without evidence, one way or the other, we must consider all the possibilities.
I believe you're both correct. At least, now we know the truth behind the levitation incident.
Yes, Gustav was very helpful when... Wait! The truth behind the levitation incident?
He meant the statue incident, Luke, didn't you, Professor?
I didn't stutter. Do you think I stuttered? I didn't stutter. No, I meant the levitation incident. I'll explain later. Right now, we need to go smack a butt.
Right! I hope Mr. Lador is there so we can smack him.
I have a feeling he may be waiting for us. I also feel like you both should probably go to the hotel. We might all die. I do not trust that man with my life. By that I mean, I trust that we're going to die. Hey, Esther, if anything happens, tell the police. It's that bad man in there.
That Alphonse has been misunderstood his entire life. Such a pity. No, I didn't want to tag you again!
Goodbye, Esther. If I'm dead, you didn't help.
breaking and entering. I mean, we're invited, either or. Don't care. Hello. Angela, we were hoping to speak to Henry. Is he here?
Yes, of course. Please, have a seat in the parlor. I'll tell Henry you want to see him.
Thank you, Angela.
Don't drink it. Don't drink it.
You still take your tea with milk, Herschel?
Why, yes. Thank you, Henry.
You're very welcome.
Don't drink it.
I would never ask a servant to wait on an old acquaintance. You may find that a bit strange, but I hope it doesn't make you uncomfortable.
Why, not at all.
Don't drink. You idiot!
I must say, Henry, the success and fame you've achieved here in town is quite astounding.
I wouldn't call myself successful. I've just been very lucky.
To what do I owe the honor of your visit?
I was hoping you could share some information with us. You own the horse racing track, correct?
That is correct.
There is evidence to suggest that one of your racing cards was used in the stone statue incident that the other night.
Absurd, cards cannot be removed from the track without my permission. Each cart has a serial number that is logged if it ever leaves the site.
So any cart can be removed as long as your permission is given.
Yes, I suppose that is one way of looking at it. What are you implying, Layton?
It seems pretty clear to me, Mr. Lador.
I am simply pointing out that the log shows that one of the carts was out the night of the incident. With your approval, Henry, the cart was removed for repairs and it was returned yesterday. Do you know anything about the repairs? There were tracks from what appeared to be a cart leading away from the scene.
Well, that's interesting.
Henry, I have reason to suspect that you were involved in last night's levitation stunt as well.
Layton, you can't be serious.
I very much can. But I'm also a dumbass for just telling you and not the police. You could have told the police you worked by it. You could have just said... Hey, there's evidence that it's his card. Get him.
No, Layton has to... what are you, Phoenix Wright, telling the bad guy? It's like, I have this evidence against you. Wait, why are you getting ready to put...
I understand that after the incident at the museum, you donated a number of works to replace the confiscated paintings. When the masked gentleman appeared to be walking on air, I believe he used a wire that was stretched across the plaza.
Ba-da-ba-ba-da-ba.
The wire must have been attached to something at the gallery.
What?
Yes, and? You could have been some you could have had some very large, heavy donations, but at the top of the gallery, so... Put at the top of the gallery so that the wire would be stable.
You have absolutely no evidence to support this nonsense, Layton.
You are aware of the drop cloths that were found near the gallery, correct? The masked gentleman used a device to lift his accomplices into the air. They then covered themselves in black cloth. From an observer's perspective, blinded by neon lights against a night sky, the accomplices seemed to simply vanish.
Professor, is that really possible?
I'm saying it, so it must be true. Yes, however, such events would require quite a bit of finessing. Financing, rather. Dalston and Henry top a very short list of suspects with wealth and connections to pull off such a thing. Well,
this isn't voice acted, right? I'm doing the voices. I'm not crazy, right? The game is not voicing this. I just want to make sure I'm not crazy right now. And I'm not talking... it is voice acted or it's not. It is not, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Because, like, with my headphones on, I cannot hear that well. And the AC going next to me, I'm like,
While I obviously can't prevent you from suspecting me, I do believe you are forgetting something important. My wealth is completely tied to the fortunes of this city. If it collapses, I'm ruined.
Yes, I keep hearing that. However, the more the masked gentleman appears, the busier Mount Deor seems to get. I find that odd. The masked gentleman has appeared in large crowds near major tourist attractions. Some locals are worried that Mount Deor is gaining a reputation for dangerous activity. But most of the talk seems to be centered around a mysterious, charismatic villain capable of performing miracles.
Professor, do you think the number of tourists has actually increased as of late?
It certainly seems on the surface that the masked gentleman's actions make for a grand staged performance. People would be very eager to flock to Mount Deor if they believed this was a limited engagement.
Layton, am I hearing you correctly? Are you actually suggesting that I hired the masked gentleman as some sort of tourism stunt?
It seems as a possibility, yes.
My wife clearly has enough faith in you to have summoned you here. But I don't trust you any further than I can throw you, Layton. Years ago, you left Randall for dead and ran off to London. You betrayed the memory of your friend, and now you have the nerve to make these ludicrous accusations in my own home. I explored every inch of that ancient death trap with nothing but Randall's notes as a guide, out of loyalty to him. You have no right to speak to me like this, and you have absolutely no idea what you're talking about.
Henry, let me explain.
We have nothing more to discuss because I'm done with you. Leave.
Very well, we shall. But please hear me out about one more thing. It's critical for the future of your city. Alphonse Dalston is not the criminal, and it's quite likely that the Masked Gentleman will appear again tonight. If you are telling the truth, then I hope to see you tonight as well. Perhaps then, we can unravel this together.
I have nothing more to say to you. Angela, please escort our guests out. Henry.
Yay!
Although the masked gentleman appeared to be walking on thin air, he was actually supported by wires strung between the museum and the arcade. His victims were actually accomplices who were lifted up by balloons and then cloaked in dark drop cloths.
This was no miracle, and the masked gentleman's accomplices were hiding somewhere in the crowd and then given the signal.
Well, that was fun.
Herschel, I'll see you out.
Okay. Let's go. No, I didn't want to talk to you. God damn it!
Can I actually go? Why didn't let me do this?
Of all the paintings, I prefer this one.
Get out of my
Get out of my study!
I just wanted to look. Sorry, it was along the way.
No, it wasn't.
I'm sorry, Herschel.
Now it's voice acted.
It is I who should apologize. I've obviously upset your husband.
I should have told the police and had him arrested instead.
No, don't worry about Henry. He gets emotional sometimes, especially concerning Randall.
It had nothing to do with Randall until he brought it up.
Understood. But I also have the feeling that Henry is hiding something.
Oh, I doubt that. Henry is an open book. He always has been.
Are you stupid?
I'm not so certain you know him as well as you pretend to.
beg your pardon? What do you mean by that, Herschel?
I intended no offense, Angela. All will become clear in time. We will soon get to the bottom of things.
The idea that she is still the masked gentleman, or Randall is. Randall could be the masked gentleman still, but she could also... I don't know.
Yes, well... Thank you, Herschel.
If she knows the masked gentleman, then she... Okay. Two and one. Interesting. Henry is clearly hiding something, which he will not or cannot tell us. What could his secret be? None of the carts may be repaired without Henry's permission. Angela has been acting strangely. She may be hiding something. Could her odd behavior be somehow related to the masked gentleman? It has been many years since I last spent any time with Angela. She seems to be quite a changed person.
What is the last one? Maybe we'll find out when we go to the theme park.
Well, that was fun.
Vice of Layton.
What can I do for you, officer? I'm not being detained, am I?
Glad I caught you. Can you come with me right away to Carnival Square? It concerns the masked gentleman case.
Of course, is something wrong?
People are dead.
Has the masked gentleman appeared again?
I don't know, sir. No, ma'am. The investigating officer on the scene said he needs to speak with you, that's all.
This case seems to be growing more complicated by the second.
Indeed, lead the way, officer.
Oh, I'll take you directly to the officer who requested you. A lot of people have trouble telling us apart. Must be the hair.
Yes, that must be it.
If you follow me, please. Okay, which way? I don't know. What? I don't want to talk to you. Do I have to? I got to.
Surprise, double surprise, a treble surprise. We meet again, unexpectedly, but you expected nothing less, no? Yes, hello, Aldous.
Good evening.
And like I said, we're going a bit overtime because we started late.
But the evening, she is not so good. Rather than good, this is night has an air of sadness. Do you not smell such air? But that air of tears, stop touching your hair. Lips a bit now that I have run into you. The deepest part of my heart is now worn.
Then I'm glad we could be of help.
But you must not leave without a gift from my gratitude. I worked on this puzzle for an entire year. Please take it.
I don't want it.
Okay. You have two wooden crates without lids, all inside. The dimensions of both crates length width are 3 centimeters. You also have numerous boxes with a length width of 20 centimeters and height of 10 centimeters. You want to pack as many of these into the crates at once as possible. If you use both crates, what's the maximum number of boxes that you can have? There mustn't be any parts sticking out. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 10. Ten.
Just a dash of puzzle solving here.
What?
Well, that won't do at all.
What?
Use both crates, what's the maximum number of... Oh. box on top of box is what I'm going to say. If box on top of box, then I can fit 6. I can fit 6 flat. 3 and 3. So 9, 12. I can fit 12 if I have the boxes stacked upside down. One upside down.
I believe I have this one.
Hell yeah, I'm a genius.
An excellent puzzle.
I redeemed myself. Hell yeah.
This is the Layton I expected. He failed and then succeeded. He of the intellect that slices through puzzles like hot comb through a pompadour. You're too kind, Altus. You got a bit of my accent. Your humility is endearing, but with me unnecessary. I know the skilled master that lurks beneath that top hat. You have brightened my evening, and I am sure you will brighten my day again. Until then, adios.
That man is very weird. Is it too late for me to say that Aldis kind of weirds me out?
Wow, how did I know?
Oh, the lights are on. Let's invade. Let's just continue going.
Who the hell are you?
Boy, I smell some inter-citizen in distress.
This city's too darn big. How could anyone find anything here?
Pardon me, sir. My name is Herschel Layton. Might I be of some service?
Not unless you're some sort of puzzle-solving genius or some. Name's Firth. New here.
What seems to be the trouble, Firth?
Lots of things. My feet hurt and my face is sweaty. But maybe you could help me with this map. It makes absolutely no sense.
You look like someone out of Pikmin 4. Wait, I didn't read. These two tourists have lost their way. Well, sightseeing, fortunately, they brought
a tourist map with them,
but it seems to have been used, well used, and it's fallen apart. Can you restore the map?
No, I can't. I cannot restore the map.
Oh man, I restored the map. I'm a genius. That's not a good fit, but also that. That can go there. That kind of fits, but no. That doesn't fit at all. Ah, that fits better. I really wish they'd all just slide over as I need them. That looks like a penis. I'm sorry. Tenabium. Hanenbium in the EU version, and I think it has a Scottish accent from when I. That's interesting. I would probably not do a Scottish accent. Mainly because I wouldn't think of it. And it would probably drip into British accidentally. And that would just be all sorts of bad. Because you never want your... Actually, it's funny. So, over the weekend, went out to eat with my aunts and cousin, with my folks. And we had a really good burger. It was really good. But that's not relevant. We went into one of the shops that was British themed because my mom wanted to the whole thing with her leg and she couldn't go because, yeah, that whole spiel. But what was my we went in and there were like these fish like vases or something, and they had the Scottish flag on them, and I'm like, in a British shop? What? Also, I think I did the map right.
Yay! For
How
me!
About this?
Smile for me, Layton. Smile.
Puzzles are made to be solved.
We're probably gonna go till 8:30 or until the chapter. Probably the chapter.
How you doing? Thanks for the help.
Wow, I saw
that great Professor Layton solve a puzzle. Professor, my brain salutes you.
We just dealt with Aldous.
I wasn't looking. You were lucky we came along, sir. The professor here is probably the world's greatest authority on puzzle solving.
Really? That's quite a claim. There was a young fella in my village who was pretty sharp with a puzzle.
Were you from my village?
He could solve a slide puzzle with his eyes closed. That boy was like a son to me. But he up and vanished a couple months back.
Okay, so probably not. Unless he's talking about the masked gentleman who's not the masked gentleman of this game, but the masked gentleman of the last game.
I think he might be here in town. But how can you find anyone in this place?
You should go to the police for help.
Ah, yes. Good luck, sir. I also suggest you speak with someone at the police station, perhaps someone not in a uniform.
Will do. Thanks for your help.
Boy, I sure hope you find his friend. Anyway, let's get back to it. I'm sure you'll have to solve the mess, gentlemen, Professor.
Okay, so, stopping at the end of this chapter would be good because the next chapter is quite a thing.
Oh! Cool!
I will do my utmost to justify your faith in my ability, officer.
Where are we going? Oh, we have to go down? Okay. I feel like I need to do your puzzle still.
Oh, you don't have one! Neat!
Still on the case, eh? Sounds like the police think they've already solved everything.
That is the opinion of the police department.
And not yours, I take it. I'm looking forward to seeing their faces when the masked gentleman shows up again. Apparently, the only thing that can convince them they're wrong is another solid blast of dangerous criminal theater.
Yep, we're all gonna die. Oh well! Percy, how are you doing?
My name's not Percy. Have you been to the amusement park yet? It's the pride of Matador. You mean Pumpkin Park, right? That's it. Didn't you know that according to local legend, some of the rides there have magic powers? Really? What kind of magic powers? It is said that if a couple rides the Ferris wheel, they'll soon be married. They're always adding in new things to see and do there. You should check it out. How charming. We'll definitely do that.
That doesn't sound like a magic trick to me. I want to ride that. Give me the power to solve a puzzle straight away.
Yeah, that'd be great.
What would be the fun of that, Luke? The satisfaction of a puzzle is the process of working out a solution.
You're right, Emmy. Never mind.
Well, whether you believe the legend or not, you should check out Pumpkin Park.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh my god, the clown.
That's weird. He said he'd be here.
I don't see any officers.
Let's look around a bit more. I feel like I need to talk to the goddamn clown. But I'm gonna check. Okay, he's over here. Okay, well, if we ignored the clown, that's fine.
There he is. What's the officer?
It's the officer who wanted to speak with you. Officer, I've got the professor here. Good work, officer. You have a bright future on the force, professor. Professor, there's someone I think you might be interested in.
Wait, who's talking? You have the same voice?
No, a slightly different. Yeah, slightly different.
No, that is a completely different voice than you just had a second ago.
No, it's not. It's the same way I've always been talking. Yeah, it's the same way!
I am very confused. Is this about the masked gentleman?
You bet it is. I wanted to say how great it was watching you on horseback chasing after that guy.
Playing Ghost Trek and my mind is reeling right now.
Yes, well, thank you.
You bet
I've lost this voice.
You bet everyone down at the station was real impressed.
I do not have to do it again, do I? Oh yeah, real impressed.
I've got to tell you, Professor, speaking to you in the flesh is an absolute honor.
Thank you, Officer.
If you want to do more...
I would never want to do that ever again in my life.
I'll stop doing nothing to make sure that everything is great.
I am never doing it.
Officer, I couldn't help but notice that didn't really have anything to do with anything important.
Sure it did. If he hadn't seen you chasing after the masked gentleman, he wouldn't have wanted to meet you so badly.
I am going to kill every single one of these buffoons. Continue the investigation. Where do I have to... I have to talk to the goddamn cloud, don't I?
Come on down to Wandering Circus.
Good to see you untangled that, sir. And your voice seems a lot less gravelly.
Yeah, I took some cough syrup. It feels good having full range of arms. It's underrated walking is nice, too.
Those flyers just grew out of nowhere. And I know that that is a thing that happens, but that means that the balloons probably are very small and could grow out of nowhere.
Now I'm just passing out a few flyers here.
A lot of people are having fun because of your hard work. You should be proud.
Thanks for saying that. One handing out of the flyers is often overlooked.
Yep, we're going to overlook you. Bye. That was a waste of time. Why did we even do that? Where do we even have to go? Where's Pumpkin Park?
Don't look now, but here comes Maddie.
That woman certainly is in a rush.
Did you hear something is going on at the Scorpion? I mean, I bet he's at the casino. Gotta go. I can't miss the masked gentleman. His next show might sell out.
What do you think, Professor? Should we investigate the casino?
Last warning did not mention the casino, but anything is possible.
As an officer of the law, as well as an excitable citizen, I am obligated to check out the casino based on a rumor. It has been an honor, Professor. Ma'am, small male child. Small male child!
If I remember the map, the casino's north, near the Merchant District. Let's head that way.
Goodbye, small male child. Have a nice day.
Do we get to make another machine gun? I hope we do.
No!
Good evening! Good evening, did you? Then I wish you a good evening.
You did. And the same to you.
Yes, but is it one? Or do we just perceive it to be one? With all the colors of the light, it's difficult to see the truth.
Yes, that does seem to be truth here in Matador.
Conducting an investigation here has been rather difficult. Hopefully you'll be able to spread your cheer while we work.
You both are hard-working, selfless, and responsible individuals. Your parents must be very proud. I shall spread the fun that I am known for throughout the city while you investigate. Surely you have time for a quick puzzle?
That's literally all we do. I hate that. I do not like this.
Three clowns are chatting about their three shared pieces of equipment.
I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the yellow box.
I keep my drum in the red box, my ball in the green, and my hat in the black.
I keep my drum in the green box and everything else in the white box.
The clowns have each put one thing into a box, and no two clowns put away the same thing. The black and green boxes are empty. Which box contains a ball?
What?
I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the yellow box. I keep my drum in the red box, my ball in the green box, and my hat in the black box.
I keep my drum in the green box and everything else in the white box.
Okay. And no two clowns put... The black and green boxes are empty, which means that the clowns that normally put stuff in them are using this stuff. So that means the yellow box is empty. And that means the white box is empty, so that means the red box has... Wait. So green and black are empty. So that means the white box should be empty. The black box should be empty. Get my drum in the red box, my ball in the green box. But we don't get the green box as an option. Wait. The clowns have each put one thing into a box. So they have a drum, a ball, and a hat. I keep my hat in the black box, and your drum and ball in the yellow. I keep my drum in the red box, my ball is in the green, and my hat is in the black. Wait. Wait. Which box contains a ball? None of them. None of them, based on what my understanding is. None of them would. I keep my drum in the red box, my ball in the green, and my hat in the black. The black and green boxes are empty. Which box contains a ball? My ball is in the green. The clowns each put one thing into a box, and no two clowns put... Okay, when they say everything else, then that means that they're lying. I keep my drum in the green box, and everything else in the white box, which is a lie. That has to be a lie. So that means the hat is in the black box, the ball is in the green, so that means the... what is in the red? Does anyone say that they keep the ball in the red? No, I'm gonna say it's the red. I'm gonna say it's the red.
Okay, here we go.
She doesn't look happy. She's wrong. I'm wrong.
Are you so
certain about that.
Yep. I didn't do it. Whoop! 1 in 3 shot! 1 in 2 shot now. Bounds of each put. I don't get this one. I keep my. The wording on this is confusing. I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the. My answer would be none of them! You have it in none of the boxes, but that's not an option. I can't choose none of them. Ball, drum, hat. They're 3 shared pieces of equipment. Clowns have each put 1 thing into a box, and no 2 clowns put away the same thing. They share it. They share the stuff. So green is empty, so screw you. Black is empty. So red either has the drum or the hat. Because we got it wrong. I'm assuming I'm not getting this one. The wording on this is stupid. I keep my drum in a green box and everything else in the white box. And everything else in the yellow box. It's either yellow or white. And I don't know if there's a way to distinguish which one would be which. That I can think of. No 2 clowns put away the same thing. Have each put 1 thing into a box. And no 2 clowns. Okay, hint coin from chat. Not actually hint coin, but just at, like, the not to trigger the alert or the channel, whatever. The command. Does each clown have an item? Or are they sharing the items? Is there only 1 hat, or do they each have a hat? They each put 1 thing into a box. I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the yellow box. This is only 1 of them put away a hat. So they share the stuff. So I keep my hat in the black box. So no, you didn't. So, you put it in the black box, and you put everything in the yellow box. Then, you put stuff in the red box and the green box. You said you put your drum in the... No, what? This doesn't make sense! I don't get this. I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the yellow. I keep my drum in the red box, my ball in the green, and my hat in the black. I keep my drum in the green box and everything else in the white box. I don't get this one at all. This one is I really wish he was showing me all the boxes at this point. Okay. How many items are there? Are there three hats, three drums, and three balls? And are they lying? Because if they're saying, if you're saying they each put one thing, and then they say, I keep my hat in the blank box and everything else, then that implies that they put two things in a box. The wording on this one is garbage. I know it's either white or yellow. I just can't figure out how. There are three relevant items, and they aren't lying. There are three relevant items?
I don't get... But steel's heavier than feathers. I don't get it.
Well, that's cheating, y'all. So many feathers.
Yes, but it's 1 kilogram. I don't get it. Hands have each put one thing into a box.
When it's also the empty part, because then that means it's like, okay, well, the black box, they say a hat's in it. It's like, okay, hat's not in it. I guess they're saying the green box because the ball is in a green box. But... what do they mean by everything else in the white box? That doesn't seem accurate. Because they're saying one thing. Everything else is not one thing. Only one of them put away a hat. But then why do they say everything else? The wording on this is just god awful.
I keep my hat in the black box and everything else in the whatever.
Wait, two of them said that they have their hat in the black box. Wait, so then they have to be lying. That doesn't make sense. No two clowns put away the same thing. Are you saying that they didn't put it away? Neither of them put things away. None of them put anything away. The red box has the drum. I can't possibly foresee which one has the ball.
They've only put three things away.
A hat, a drum, another drum. Black box got a hat. And my hat, unless they share the hat.
There's a hat in the green box normally, I'm gonna say. And I may be wrong. Maybe not. Maybe they don't. Maybe there's only a drum and a ball in the green box normally.
You both put a hat in the black box. And if the
black box is empty, that does not mean... Okay, yellow, 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 yellow!
All in a day's work.
It's the yellow box, it's the black box, is empty, neither one nor two put their hats in there, into it, which means three must have put away her hat in the white box. What, the green box is also... Okay, I have no idea, but I got it right in the end, so screw this puzzle.
How was it? Was it fun? Did you enjoy it at all?
I hated it.
It was not. Thank you, Juggles, for wasting our time.
With all the chaos lately, I've had to work extra hard to make people smile. I'm sad to see that you're frowning, and your eyebrows are furling at me.
Should we kill him?
Maybe later.
Sounds like a plan.
Who the hell are you?
The casino down here at the end of Chance Avenue must be where all the commotion is.
Let's head that way then. We have no time to lose.
How close am I to the end of the chapter?
Professor, do you see that nervous-looking man at the entrance?
Yes, something odd is going on here.
Oh no, oh no, how could this happen? What can I do? Are my shoes untied?
No, I'm wearing loafers. Good. Wait, no, still loafers. Good.
Maybe we should just move on, Professor.
Let's just see if we can help out here.
Professor! Professor Layton! Oh! Hey, am I glad to see you? I've been looking all over town for you. It is you, right? Okay, so I'm the accountant. You've heard of me, right? No, I'm the accountant for Dalston and Ladors. I have some critical information, but I'm getting ahead of myself. I should start with some of the background on Montador, right? Yes. The city was founded by Henry Lador, but a big part of his expansion came from his competition with Alphonse Death. Dalston. But since Dalston's arrest, you see his business is taking a hit. Quite a hit. Yeah, my name is Murphy, by the way. Sorry.
Good to meet you, Murphy. You say Dalston's businesses are in trouble?
Yes, that's what I said. Isn't it? Well, that's what I meant to say. We can't everyone have numbers in their blood. Look at this.
How close am I to the thing? How does this have to do with numbers?
Halfway? Oh.
Should I end here then? Because I don't know if we're going to get to the next chapter, like, within the next 15 minutes.
How does this have to do with numbers?
A, B, C, D, and E run a bakery. A cake shop. Okay, just you go up there. C and I both work closely to the bakers and the cake shop. Wait, but who? Wait. Why do they have to do it like that? Okay, and I can't do both.
Okay.
Okay. C and I both work close to the bakers and the cake shop. So, no to A. Also, no to C. I'll say you're C. C and I both work close to the bakers and the cake shop, which means that, oh, I can barely see that. In B's case, and I haven't dropped by the cafe for ages. So, Yoop. Yoop. D and I never bake bread. Well, I'd hope not, because you're already counted there, but, Miss... D and I never break bread, so you are not there. Neither A nor B run the bookshop. Okay. E and I often visit the cafe and the grocers. And the grocers. C and I both work near the groceries. Grocers. Well, that's useless information. I already know that. But also, you go to the cafe, which is more important information. C and I both work near the grocers. Hello, C. So, from this, A, you run the cafe. If A runs the cafe, that doesn't really help much at all. Because any of the others could be literally anyone else. Other than the fact that A, so A cannot be you, so then that does leave you. Wait. No, yes. Yes. Okay, so then that leaves you there at the baker's. You there, and you there. I'd say stop movement progress here, mainly because there is an event soon, which might take some time to do. Okie dokie!
How about this?
I did it. We're gonna end on a good puzzle.
Made to be
hooray!
Solved.
I feel like I'm gonna have to do a lot of Layton reading. Now you understand the complexity and the beauty of our local economy, yes? All right, it's really very simple. Mr. Lador founded this town in the middle of nowhere. This spot we're standing on was just a small desert oasis. This town kind of begins here.
Yes, I can see that. It's a central point of the whole city.
You said you had some critical information. Quite. As I mentioned, I love my work. Did I mention that? Well, I do. Even if I didn't, yeah, anyway. So when Mr. Dalston was arrested, his businesses took a nosedive. More than a nosedive, really, a whole face dive. Without competition, Mr. Dalston, Mr. Lador, can just kick back and still make a fortune. The problem here is it's social or physical damage, it's economical, and that's the worst of all types of damage. But don't Mr. Lador's businesses also suffer if the tourists are scared away? Yes, that would be true if it were true. But if it were true, the fact that the tourists are pouring in to see the miracles would also be false. Why, just this month, Mr. Lador's overall net profits were up. Let's see, adjacent city tax, carry the two.
Isn't that information confidential?
Oh, no. I've done it again. Yes, of course, it's confidential. Wait, did I actually say anything? Let's just pretend that you never heard that last part. In fact, there never was a last part, which may not actually be the untruth.
I understand. I do. Are you saying that Dalston's arrest has actually helped Henry?
Yes, you do understand. I hope I don't say too much. Did I say too much? Was it just enough? Professor, it seems that Mr. Lador has the motive and the opportunity.
Certainly does, Emmy. He seems like a very bad man.
Oh, you know what? No, we're reading that next time.
Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this half unintentionally. I mean, we kind of went normalish time just later in the night because we started late. Because I'm an idiot. The VOD channel is linked below. Psychonauts last part went up today. So if you want to watch me struggle through the meat circus, you can. It's linked below. Right there. Right down there. I got lost in the meat circus. Twitter is also linked below. You can follow there if you so wish. I don't post if the stream goes live there anymore, but you can follow if you so wish. God knows if that site's gonna still be alive in the coming days. And yes, it's sad that I say that almost every day at this point. Man, I date my content. Hard. That said, but if you want a better way to contact me, you can join the sub Discord. I would say you can message me on Twitter, but apparently there's a limit if you're unverified. You can't message as many people now. Isn't that great? But you can message me here, or if you know me on other Discord servers, you can message me and you can join the sub Discord server. You do not need to be subscribed to join, but you can message me and I can add you. But if you do subscribe, you get to join the server with no issue as long as your account is linked to your Discord and Twitch. And you can use the emotes that you can use here, anywhere on any Discord server without the need of Nitro. You don't need to be verified to use those emotes on Discord as long as you're subscribed here. Anyways, I'm getting distracted. If I reach 40 subscribers, I will be doing a Pokemon Nuzlocke. I do not know which game, and I do not know if it'll be randomized. It'll be determined when it is determined. What is a good raid message? I feel like we did nothing in this stream. We did not make that much progress. Oh, that hurts. Boop, 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 boop. Woo. Who is streaming? What is a good raid message? Boop, boop. Oh no, horses. Maybe. 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 Maybe, maybe, maybe. We're gonna raid Jiggy. With, oh no, horses. You know what? We didn't get a single horse puzzle, though. That was nice. The game had pity. After that stupid one chess puzzle. God help me. Anyways. So much for watching. Enjoy. Tomorrow we will hopefully beat the game this week. We will see what we see. Have a good night.